This is a circle. It has no name. Let's call it Jim or Steve or maybe Bob. Yeah, I like Bob. Bob's got circumference. No, it's not a disease. It's the distance around the outside. It's like perimeter, but circularly. So how do we find his circumference? We need pi and his radius. But what if all we know is his diameter? How do we find the radius we desire? Just divide by two, that's all you gotta do. Cut it in half and then you're ready to go. And we can find out so many things, like his circumference and his area too. 2 pi r and pi r squared, solve them both and then you're well prepared. Whoa. Whoa. Bob the circle, he's not just circumference. He's got chords and secants and an arc besides. He's got himself a pretty little angle inscribed, and Bob's got it all. I guess you could say he's got a tangent to the left and then a secant to the right. Now that he knows his circumference, he can even circumscribe. But how did we find his circumference? We needed pi and his radius. But what if all we know is his diameter? How do we find the radius we desire? Just divide by two, that's all you gotta do. Cut it in half and then you're ready to go. And we can find out of so many things, like his circumference and his area too. 2 pi r and pi r squared, solve them both and then you're well prepared. And what if all we know is his diameter? How do we find the radius we desire? Just divide by 2, that's all you gotta do. Cut it in half and then you're ready to go. And we can find out so many things, like his circumference and his area too. 2 pi r and pi r squared, solve them both and you're well prepared. Whoa.
Point at the zero and then shake your head.